What are you about to do?
Am I in the right zoom?
Hold on, let me try and play around.
You can use these two.
It's that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
And does it record audio? Does it record audio though?
Yeah, it should be recording audio.
Okay, alright.
Ready?
Mitchell Mandrasi.
Mitch Mandu. In the proper uniform.
Duty.
Alright, so we're going to clean the sea strainer. Of the port sized sea strainer.
Yep.
And
I think this is a better angle when we do it.
Yep.
That's a lot better. So we should do that.
And we are all prepared with proper PPEs, eyeglass, earmuffs, gloves.
Dude, you should probably do YouTube. You should be a YouTuber or something.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna so try to this Apple PC into our YouTube.
Okay, I think I'm gonna hang the zoom.
So that it will be easier for the graders. Using the graders.
Should I turn it off now or?
No. Continue.
Oh, it's gonna be continuous the whole time.
Yeah.
Like we already started.
Yeah. No worries. Hold up. Because we are going to clean the sea strainer, I'm going to take all the electronics on myself out, so that there's not any damage to my stuff due to the overpressure and the sea strainer.
Wait, hold on, dude. You gotta restart. We gotta cut that.
Why?
Just cut it. I'm sorry. Right.
Hold on.
I was.
All right, now it's foaming. It's real time. All right, Jurassic. No more messing up.
All right.
I'm Mitch Mandu. As per Seaproject Systems, push number 14 E, that additional part, I'm going to film the video for me cleaning and changing the sea strainer. Alright, the sea strainer is a filter device that we place after the sea chest pipe to filter out all the debris from sea. So therefore, from being cut by the sea strainer, maybe some very weird stuff like a fish or some stuff.
Okay.
So we'll have to clean that periodically. And the procedure for cleaning that, first we'll have to get the watch officer's permission. Describe of how we are going to clean that.
0630.
Have the watch officer to supervise us in case of any safety stuff. In the actual operation, we are going to shut off the isolating valve. One of the valves actually shuts off the sea chest, and other shut off the pipe from the sea strainer to the rest of the saltwater system. To do that, we have to make sure the sea strainer and the sea chest of the other side of the saltwater system are open, so that by the time we start changing it, the saltwater system will have enough saltwater in it.
No pressure.
All right, let's go.
There it is, piss in the sink, from the sink in the piss.
Good job.
Side. isolating one of the C string there on the stepper side. So now the C stress on the stepper side is open and there's seawater coming through from the stepper side. And so now we're going to close the C chest on the port side and close the isolating valve of the C strainer on the port side. Then we're gonna use wrench with a crisscross fashion to take out the bolt. And then we're going to remove the top plate along with the gasket. That should be able to expose us the C-strainer or the filter version, filter part of the C-strainer.
Yeah, well, right.
Jurassic? I'm right here.
The generator will shut down.
Alright, so where was I?
It'll also shut down.
No, where was I? Oh yeah, we're going to take out the C-strainer or the filter. We're going to up deck, use a water hose to rinse off all the debris that's left in it. And then if needed, we're going to find a brush, brush off all the debris that broke in the hose. By doing that, the C-strainer or the filter should now be clean or good enough for camera work. And then we're going to take the filter back to the C-strainer, put in there, put on the top plate, tie all the bolts back, and then open the isolating valves and the C-chest, and then the operation should be finished.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go. bong!
well enough. So we're gonna use the water hose and hopefully you will have a higher water pressure. Higher water pressure, but this little filter, it got clogged too much. We're going to spray this thing out and hopefully find something to hold it.